guys, my name is Komal Komalala Ansari, and today I am joined with Kevin Strike Chung to cast the qualifiers for the G4 League of Legends tournament. Today, it is Unite versus Equilibrium. So it's Unite on the blue side and Equilibrium on the purple side, well, red side. So let's see how it goes.
Thank you for the introduction, and here we go.
Waiting time for with those bands. First one will be Gnar.
Oh, it's pretty standard ban at the moment. I'm not too sure about the 5.1 patch, however, it's a pretty much standard ban for everyone in general. They don't want to deal with that Gnar in the top lane.
Yeah, that's pretty typical. I think we'll see Gnar being one of the highly contested champions. We did see him being banned, I think it was in all three games in the previous best of two series that we had last week. So we will see him being contested quite a bit. Now, we saw the first ban out by Equilibrium is going to be that Graves, and we know Graves is pretty strong as AD carry at the current moment.
Especially in the bot lane. I mean, his burst damage, especially in the early levels, he can easily get level 2, especially if he chooses to take Q level 1 and Q the minions. And it's nice to get that Q on top of the enemy as well for that nice trade.
Yeah, Zir being the second ban for Unite is quite a strong mid laner. It has a lot of poke potential and provides a lot of... he's pretty much a nuisance in the mid lane. It's really hard to deal with him, especially if you're playing a short-ranged AP carry in the mid lane. And then Xerath going to be the second ban there for Equilibrium.
Xerath and Azir, both very poke-reliant champions, especially in that mid lane. It seems like both teams do not want to deal with that. And there's a Rek'Sai coming in, who is, again, she has been nerfed slightly in this patch. Reduced scalings on Q, and she is, in my opinion, is generally a strong champion as well. The ganks, the tunnels, the global presence from her ult, and the final ban is Jarvan.
Yeah, we saw Jarvan being played a lot as well before, and a lot of competitive play as well. He's a great early level ganker as well, so he brings a lot of presence to those lanes and provides a lot of help. And then obviously at level 6, we saw this multiple times before, that with that cataclysm, it brings a lot of CC to team finds. But these are a lot of targeted bans as well, because both these teams are really targeting one another, getting rid of their strengths. So we see Boosh now hovering over that Sion. He does lock it in, and Boosh is famously known for that Sion pick, so he's going to go for that this time around as well.
Yes, and I remember correctly, I've seen Boosh's Sion in Four Nations, and he's played it rather well. I mean, there are very rare... You rarely see players play Sion, especially in the top lane. However, I've seen Boosh play extremely well, and it'll be interesting to see how this goes into whatever Equilibrium decides to pick.
Yeah, they're hovering over that Urgot and Mundo. Now, not 100% sure if they're going to go for it. They're just doing it for the lulz, but we'll see now exactly. See, we haven't seen Equilibrium play before. Some of these players are seen before in the previous Irish League of Legends tournaments, but some of them are quite new, but the team together is a completely different roster, so it's going to be interesting to see how these newcomers are going to face off against Unite, especially Unite being one of the top teams in Ireland. So that is Lee Sin being locked in, and Annie as well.
And Lee Sin is a standard jungler pick. I mean, when you ban out Jarvan and Rek'Sai, they're very limited in terms of what junglers are left, which have a lot of presence in the early game. And Lee Sin, in general, is an all-around great jungler. His early pressure, his mobility, and if at least the players are able to insane, that's pretty much a hard engage right there, or a good pick. And a Zin being picked up as well. And another early, a strong early jungler.
Yeah.
Very good ganks.
Yeah, Zin's like one of Razor's top played junglers as well. He's really comfortable and he's played a lot in the previous seasons as well, so I'm not surprised if he goes for it. Kha'Zix is open as well. He could choose to go for that if he feels like it, but it looks like he's going to be sticking with that Yin Zhao, so we'll be locking in. We'll see what Endlimit decides to pick, and we'll be picking his own champion for the mid lane, or we'll be picking up something else for his team. We'll find out shortly. On a few seconds left of the countdown, it is going to be Corki for... is now Hush, as AD carry used to be Hustlin, so he's now Hush.
And yeah, Corki's is a good pick in general. He has really good poke damage, he has nice mixed damage in the form of both AD and magic, so it's really hard for the enemy team to itemize against that Corki. And with the Annie, I mean, that's a very... I'm guessing that's Annie in the bot lane. Could be in the mid lane, but we'll see. And Sivir being hovered over. Sivir's a really good pick against Corki with that spell shield, because Corki relies a lot on casting. He's a AD carry. However, he's a more spell casting orientated AD carry, such as Lucian, Graves, and Corki, obviously.
Yeah. It looks like it's going to be hovering over a Urgot as well. Now I'm going to switch it back to the Rumble. That's more what I want to see as well, and what you'd more typically see. And it's going to be Sivir for AD carry. And oh, they're switching it back over again. Maybe Cho'Gath. I'm not sure if it might change over the last second. No, they won't. It is definitely going to be that Cho'Gath in the top lane, I presume. And it's going to be Sivir for AD carry.
I really like Cho'Gath as a pick. I mean, he's been buffed in the recent patches. I mean, his cooldown on his ultimate has been reduced, especially when he decides to nom a minion or a monster. So that's a slight buff on his part. And Cho'Gath in general, if played well, he just has to farm and sustain any trades you do against Cho'Gath. And if he trains evenly, he usually wins out in terms of his passive. He has really good sustain, and it's really hard to send or force a Cho'Gath outside of lane.
Yeah, it would be quite dangerous. And now I can see Coco Pops hovering over. Ooh, was Leona. I would like to see that go on Coco Pops. But he does play Thresh a lot as well. I'm not going to go for that, it seems. Still has a good few seconds. He is covering through every single support champion before he selects which one he's actually going to be going for. But we now have to see what is going to be the mid lane champion. Looks like it's going to be Ahri and Janna as support.
And Janna and Ahri comes in. Janna has always been a very strong pick, and with that shield provides a lot of trade potential within the bot lane. And in general, it's just a very safe pick. I mean, she has that ult for disengage. She has her Q, the tornado. It, against Sivir, it might not be so great, because depending on how far away she's trying to like charge up that tornado, the Sivir can easily predict and spell shield that for some mana. But it looks like bot lane for Unite is just going to be a Corki, Janna, and a safe farming lane. But I do like the Ahri pick in that mid lane. It's a very safe pick, because they don't know what Equilibrium could bring into the mid lane. I mean, as we mentioned previously, it could be that Annie in the mid. However, I'm expecting something different.
Yeah, I agree with you on that. And looks like it's going to be LeBlanc, and that is locked in. So it is going to be Annie in that lane. And it is going to be LeBlanc for the mid lane, and we know that it's pretty much... Yeah, LeBlanc does counter Ahri somewhat to a certain extent, and it does become difficult for Ahri in lane, but I think the most important thing about Ahri is landing that charm in lane if you want to harass, and if you want to outplay a LeBlanc, which has been done several times before, but it's really hard as well for Ahri, because if with LeBlanc and a distortion, you can jump right in, do harass, and jump back out, so you might mistime your charm a little bit. But that's her key focus in the laning phase. And obviously when it comes to team fights as well, you really want that CC from that charm.
Yeah, and I was just about to say, it could be a LeBlanc pick right here. I mean, a LeBlanc is a really good pick. It's really hard for Zin. Zin, a very early dependent champion, he's really strong with ganks. However, it's really difficult to gank a LeBlanc, like you said, with that distortion jumping and... It depends how both mid laners play it out, but a lot of it seems like both teams have a lot of pick. And with that Annie, they got the Flash Tibbers engage, the Lee Sin for the possibly insect, and they have Cho'Gath, this very strong front line with a ton of CC. Looking at Unite's teams as well, it's got that they've got some decent hard engage with that Sion. They have quite. They have really good book actually on the side of Corki, and depending on the Ahri, she can make picks, she can do some harassment.
Yeah, and just looking at the lane matchups now as well, Boosh in the top lane on Sion, which we've seen him play plenty of times before, and is extremely comfortable on it, and now Dalker is going to be playing Cho'Gath. We have seen Dalker play before in previous tournaments, but I haven't seen him play Cho'Gath before, so that's going to be interesting to see how he deals with Boosh on that Sion.
And nothing really out of surprising here, aside from the Janna with Ignite, which is, I like the Ignite on supports, because if they, especially when they use it early on in the lane, it grants lane dominance. But
yeah,
when you're going with a Corki and Janna, that could be a very scary lane.
Yeah, definitely. And in the jungle, Razor on a really comfortable champion, which is Jin Zhao, and Toe Grinder. Seen him play before as well, and he's going to be playing Lee Sin as extremely mobile junglers and really good for early level ganking, really good for counter ganking as well. And we know that Razor is really focused on counter ganking, especially in those early levels of the game. So will these two junglers be sitting there counter jungle one another? Or let's see how much of an impact they will have in that early laning phase as well as when it comes to the mid to late game. And Enlimit on Ahri, haven't seen him play that in a while. And Nevermore on LeBlanc. So we're just talking about this matchup.
Exactly. And what's going to be the biggest influence within the games of both teams is whether Razor or Toe Grinder on that Lee Sin, which jungler is going to have the most impact? Both very early, strong early junglers, and we'll see which one gets which members or lanings through the early game into the mid game, because you really want to get that long snowballing if possible. But once that Ahri hits level 6, it becomes a little bit harder to get any ganks off, unless Nevermore on LeBlanc can land that chain.
Yeah, they're probably going to be looking to initiate onto Enlimit to get his Spirit Rush on cooldown before probably Toe Grinder comes around for a gank. Might be looking to set up in that kind of way. And the last matchup is the bot lane, which is going to be Corki and Janna against a Sivir and Annie. Now, Annie, the old school support that we see, and really good as well, works well with Sivir. They have provided a lot of harass, especially with Annie's long range auto attacks. You can just auto attack for a good while, especially in the early levels. But we know that Corki is extremely strong as an AD carry and worth a Janna, especially with additional AD that she gives on those shields. It's poking just becomes even more hard to deal with.
And on the side of Unite, I mean, as a Zin, ganking bot lane might possibly be the best choice. Sivir is fairly immobile, especially when she doesn't have her ult. And same with Annie, I mean, that's the downside of Annie. She has a lot of damage and a lot of poke. However, what she lacks is movement. She has no dashes to escape any like extreme ganks, and with that Zin it would be very scary, and all she really has is a stun to stop any potential ganks. But once the summoners are down, that bot lane is very vulnerable unless the Sivir can actually spell shield those key spells in time.
Yeah, and it's important to land that spell shield on time or else it becomes a bit of a sticky situation, especially as you said, they are pretty immobile champions, Annie, anyways. The only safety that she has is her stun and Sivir on the hunt when she hits level 6. But we are on the rift now, we're waiting for the champions to be released. They're so impatient, they're looking to get out as fast as they possibly can, running towards the jungle to get that vision down. Ping's already coming out. So, are we gonna see maybe invades? Looks like they're all pretty much spreading around. And probably looking to get that vision down around the jungle.
And Equilibrium level 1 is actually really good. I mean, you can see that Cho'gath now, Dalker, going towards the top side of their jungle and warding up the scenes before this invade to spot any potential sneak attacks from Unite in their top side jungle.
Yeah, there's a ward in that tri-rush on Unite's side. They're all sitting down here, they're grouping up together, maybe looking to spot somebody up, but Hush should see them coming if they do choose to do so. Lurking around the area.
Like they've been spotted by that bush ward by the Corki as well. Oh. Bit of poke coming off from the Corki.
Yeah.
Onto the Taylor Swift. Backing off. Get out of my jungle.
Thought we'd never say something like that. But yeah. Taylor Swift did. Okay, I'm just going to say Annie because this is too distracting. Annie did have her stun up. So I'm surprised she didn't use it, but probably noticed that Janna was alongside there as well. Was no point wasting that. So they have a good bit of vision down alongside the river and the entrances to their jungle. Trying to play it safe for now. Don't see any invades going on. Lee Sin maybe looking to get the ward, does get that ward down on the blue. So looks like Razor's probably going to start off there first.
And this actually gives both teams information of where about the jungle is starting. I mean, they saw Toe Grinder, first of all, warding Unite's blue. But then they see that he's going to run towards his own topside jungle, so they know that he's starting either at red or most likely double golems.
And the harass already begins in the mid lane. Nevermore not missing a chance to jump right in and try to get something down to Enlimit. I see there's probably constant harass going back and forth between the both of them, because Ari has a great potential of harassing as well. And pretty see it going even in the mid lane, even though a little bit of CS lead there for Enlimit already.
And what we saw in the bot lane there was the Corki and the Janna took the double golems, so they're still taking the level 1 camp. And I think that's a really good idea. However, the depending on which bot lane actually gets that level 2 first really impacts who is going to win the lane, especially in the early game.
Yeah, we always say that. We always wait and see who gets that first level 2, but Enlimit in the mid lane using that Orb of Deception for a little bit of damage. Oh, Blank throws some back down as well. So, oh, the charm hits as well. The Orb of Deception goes right. Use the distortion jump right in. Ignite being popped down to both of them. Flash being used, but flashes right after. Will that be enough? It does. First blood goes to Nevermore. Nicely played by the both of them.
Yep, I mean, LeBlanc actually has the upper hand in the level 2. Her damage is still exceptionally high with that Q and the W, and when she procs the Q, the Sigil of Silence, sorry, with the W, it does a crazy amount of damage. And Ahri, even though she lands the charm, if she doesn't follow up with an orb, with the Q, it doesn't really do exactly that much damage. And Ahri itself, as a champion, she doesn't have much level 2 burst damage. So for her to go all in on a LeBlanc when they were both level 2 was a bit of a mistake. And she also, unfortunately, ignited the wrong the wrong LeBlanc. She ignited the clone, it seems.
Yeah, that was a bit unfortunate. Would have been maybe an even trade if we weren't for that. But looking at the other lanes, they are pretty much playing it passive. Looks like actually Toegrinder's coming down to the bot lane to try and get a gank, but Wave's quite pushing. I don't know if they'll be able to get something onto Coke Pops or Pushy in the bot lane. So they're just able to push that in now. The top lane actually, Dalker going hard onto Boosh, trading back with him. They do spot Coke Pops in that brush, just hiding there, but they still don't know that Foregrounder is around the area. And again in the mid lane, and Enlimit just throwing down some harass. Same goes for the top lane. But Razor's here in the bot lane, so 3v3, they do go in, right in onto Coco Pops. He said like night down, he has a flash away, but Razor just fighting onto the same, gets that kill for himself. They're now gonna focus. Andy just trying to get away, but that's gonna be a kill for Hush. Now Mr. Irish is the only one left, but he's gonna survive. That's a nice 2 kills for Unite in that bot lane.
Yeah, and I feel Toegrinder spent a little too much time in that bot lane, especially standing in the bush. However, nothing was being done. And whilst he was standing in that bush, he was actually there first for a good few seconds. But waiting in the bush and not acting or creating any pressure whatsoever allowed Razor the time to come bot lane and potentially counter gank.
Yeah, that was a brilliant counter gank, but he didn't waste any time, came right in and went right in onto Lee Sin, and so got himself his bot lane kill and himself one as well. So Miss Irish needs to be a little bit careful not to get overly aggressive. He still has a good bit of mana as well. He's trying to farm up and push as well. Now Annie is back into the lane, so pretty even for them both, but it's gonna be hard giving a kill onto Corki. It just makes things even more difficult. So gets his Triforce, gets his Sheen. It's gonna be even more damages being output by him, especially from his abilities. Since we did say earlier, he is more focused on his abilities. But looks like Mr. Arch is trying to throw something down onto Hush. He's gonna face him a little bit, but he's gonna back off for now.
And you can already see the CS differentials, especially in the bot lane with the Corki on 40 and the Sivir on 26. Just from that gank alone, it's really helped Key into that, just to speed up his level or his power spike into the mid game. I mean, with that kill and with the assist and with the CS lead, he's going to have an item advantage and an XP level advantage. And he currently already has the lane in his control, and you can see Razor trying to get another little gank in the top lane. But meanwhile, in the top
lane. In the top lane, Boosh in a really bad situation. Here's Toegrinder. Doesn't land that Sonic Wave. He's going to follow it up in a second. Waits for that and flashes. This might be easy to slow him down. And Feral Scream takes him out. So that was nicely played by Dalker. He wasn't being impatient. He just sat there waiting for Lee Sin to come in for that gank.
And those are both flashes down in the top lane, which makes Sion an even bigger target for that Lee Sin. So maybe we might see Toegrinder coming back in the top lane. But meanwhile, in the mid lane, we see Razor trying to get a nice gank in.
Yeah, Nevermore not overextending that lane just yet. Limit did seem a bit too antsy for that engage, but Razor's just go back into the jungle. Not gonna disengage yet. Nevermore is under the safety of his tower, so it's just pointless sticking around. Especially now having that distortion off cooldown. This makes it a lot safer for him in his lane.
And I like what Enlimit's doing is on that Ahri by pushing LeBlanc into a tower. It's a nice way of playing against LeBlanc. I mean, if you shove the wave constantly into her tower, she has to make a choice between using her spells to clear the minion wave or to use it on you. And if she uses it on against you, that means she's going to have a harder time last hitting under the tower.
Yeah, and we can see already there's a bit of boards being cleared around the dragon area, and Rares decides to go right in onto Anne. He does stun him up, uses the ignite as well. Tonal Grinder taking his way down as well. Trying to chase down Razor, but he's gonna be safe. He does have Cocoa Pops and Hush by his side. So it looks like Dragon is a target for Unite anyways, and Equilibrium are gonna react to that. They're not gonna let the first dragon go to them. And we've seen this plenty of times as well before, when one team takes control of the dragon, it's really hard for the opposing team to try and get that control back from them. And they struggle a lot in maintaining dragons. But here in the mid lane, the spirit runs right in, misses the orb of deception. Might have been enough for that to kill, probably maybe another auto attack as well, but unfortunately for Enlim, he doesn't get anything. And just in the top lane as well, Dalker and Boosh, just the same kind of going on for the both of them, just trying to harass one another. Darkler just gonna keep going this with his Warble Spikes. Just gonna back off due to that wave.
And I like what happened in the bot lane, especially with the Razor going in on the Annie. And Annie playing really aggressively and blowing ignites onto him. And I liked why. I liked how Razor backed off. I mean, he possibly spotted the Lee Sin with that ward around the banana bush. But most people you'd see actually continue aggressing on the support when they catch him out. But I liked how he actually backed off and didn't tunnel vision into that kill.
Ooh, Enlimit has to burn that flash, yeah. Nicely done by him just to avoid that sonic wave.
And that flash being down, it's really gonna hurt Enlimit, especially in that mid lane against LeBlanc, who still has a flash and ignite.
Yeah, now having that spirit rush available as well, since it does have a very high cooldown before you even get CD or you hit level 2 on the ultimate, it becomes difficult as well, because you know when that's down, you don't really have any form of escape. Now that flash is down as well, I'm pretty sure Nevermore is going to take full advantage of that situation. But in the meantime, we do have a pause coming out. We always see a pause. There's nothing new about that. It's pretty typical in any G-Series League of Legends tournament, so hopefully we'll see them come back. It was a bit of a DC issue and we should resume in a few seconds, so nothing too huge. Should be heading back to the game. But as we can see, Dragon's still available, almost about 9 minutes, almost going to be hitting 10 minutes. So we'll see. There should be a setup soon, I wouldn't be surprised. Jungler's probably looking to gank a lane and head straight for that. That's what we typically see. And Unite, we know, like to go for them dragons pretty early, don't tend to hesitate to go for those.
Now would be the perfect time. They just sent the Ahri back and they saw how low her she was in mana. She burned her flash, they just gave a blank blue, and look at it now. Equivalent growing straight for that dragon because they know that Ahri has gone back.
Yeah. They don't have vision down on it either, so it looks like they do now. Next bops. That's gonna be cleared. And we're trying to go in from the side, but not really doing anything. Razor here trying to deny that, probably take a smite steal. Those get stunned up, they're gonna focus him now as well. The dragon's still taken down, nope, he's gonna focus that, he's gonna focus right into the fight. Porky gets himself a kill, and Limit tries to go on in. Gonna have to use a spirit rush right out. Cocoa Pops in the dragon pit, same with Hush. Jump flashes right in. Flash out as well, here comes Boosh. The ultimate hits right into Mr. Iron. The charm does miss, now Dalton trying to focus down the rest of the team. He's too squishy, he's been taking down a few more hits, and Ahri does pick up that kill for herself. Now gonna chase on over to get Annie. Oh, a kill for Hush as well. So that is a 2-for-0 trade. 2-for-1 trade, sorry. Favor of Unite.
Yeah, and Hush just got huge that fight. I mean, he's 3-0-2 now with his Sheen, and I wouldn't even be surprised if he has enough for a Triforce on his next pack. And looks like they're trying to pick up this dragon as well, picking up those lost pieces from the Equilibrium's dragon attempt.
Yeah, but Toe Grinder is back. Maybe trying to switch the roles now, try to get this steal, but she's doing a great job trying to keep him off of it, and taking quite low as well. Yeah, a lot of damage coming out, and that's just a Sheen on him as well, so that's typically what you see.
Yeah, that dragon fight didn't exactly go in Equilibrium's favor. I mean, I felt as if Sivir could have came a bit earlier and they could have maybe secured that dragon. But what Equilibrium did was, I feel like there was a miscommunication there in whether or not they should have went, they should have taken dragon down, or whether they should have killed Zin as soon as he came in, because they got the dragon down to around 1,200 KHP, and then they decided to turn on the Zin. But by that time, they were all taking bits of damage from the dragon. Togrinder was pretty low already, so in the end, they didn't get anything apart from that one kill, and they lost dragon at the same time.
That was quite unfortunate for them, even though it looked like it was being set up nicely for them as well, sending the end limit back. But spent too much time, they were misfocused, and they didn't know whether to fight or go for the dragon, and they ended up losing out in both cases. But yet again, Boosh and Dalek are going to see that in the top lane. Nice spell shield by Sivir to lock out that Foster's Bomb. Dalek is taking a good bit of damage from Boosh, he's quite tanky, doing Zephyr Elscream as well, to try and silence him. But they're just gonna keep trading. We're gonna see this typically in the top lane, but the Trollgrinder is here now as well to use a smite. Because his dragon's rage to kick him back right to the Vorpal Spikes, has to flash away, but he's slowed, uses the ultimate to try and hit them back, but he's taking quite low. I don't know if he'll get away. The Sonic Wave does miss, he might be able to survive. Here comes Razor to help him out. Has to do the ultimate to make them both back off. Some nice timing by Razor to help Boosh in the top lane.
Those are some really nice plays made in the top lane. I mean, the Lee Sin, W to the ward to kick him back, the perfectly timed flash from Boosh, and then he tried to ult away, to run away with that Psion ult. However, Dalko was one step ahead of him and flashed right on top of him to deny that speed of Psion running away. And it was nice to play by everyone. Luckily, Boosh managed to escape, unfortunately, for Equilibrium. Lin was there at the right time. No kills on either team.
Yeah, I feel like they might have been able to pick up that kill if Razor didn't show himself or didn't make it on time. But anyways, it leaves Dalker in the top lane. A little bit of time to chunk away at that tower. And bot lane, not too aggressive. I expected to be a bit more aggressive, but Annie and Sivir are super aggressive, especially with level 6 when that Tibber is available, and especially on the hunt. But they are losing out on a little bit. Corki is 3-0-2. And is building towards that Triforce, or there it is a bit difficult, but yet they are still managing to push the wave, and that's kind of expected. Sivir does have a lot of wave clear with that boomerang and the ricochet, so they're trying to even out the lane as well, and they're probably not going to engage. I don't expect them to engage unless if someone on either side gets caught or jungler shows up. Now both bot lanes are just looking to farm.
And that's a strength of Sivir. I mean, even if you are slightly behind in laning the bot lane, she can still just shove in the wave, back off, or just shove in the wave and then play a bit safer. She doesn't have to fight for that farm as much as most AD carries do. And it's really hard for Corki and Janna, especially with that combination, to hard engage onto the Sivir. For example, when Sivir pushes the lane, it's really difficult for the Corki, for example, to like Valkyrie in. Like that puts them out of position slightly, and they've always they've always got the Annie stun to follow up, so even if Unite's bot lane want to engage, they can always disengage. Equilibrium's bot lane can always disengage, sorry.
Yeah, that's true. So, looks like Razor's coming around the side as well. They're looking for an engage. The shield is already on him. Goes right in onto Sivir to focus. Annie just trying to run away, save her life, and she's gonna make it out as well, and so does Sivir. So, they're just gonna leave them for now. Probably look to push the wave, maybe try and get a good bit of damage onto that tower. It hasn't really been touched at all, and that's really difficult as well against someone like Sivir, who has so much wave clear.
Yeah, and you can see just the top lane, the brutes just battling it out.
Yeah.
Barely losing any health.
Here comes Togrinder, the bot lane. Valkyrie being used. Does land that Sonic Wave, but nice. Soon by Hulk Pops to push them right back. The TP coming in by Boosh. They're gonna try and engage this using the ultimate and focusing down the Annie. The down but Cho comes in as well with the TP, and they're gonna have to turn the fight right back around onto Boosh. They're trying to chase him down. Tornado does knock them back, so that's the greatness of Janna. So much CC utility for the team. It is now basically a 5v5 in the bot lane. Looking to get these towers down, probably looking for an engage as well soon enough. They're all quite low, so it's quite risky for both sides. Pokebop needs to be careful, almost got locked down by those chains. Decide to go in on taking a lot of damage from that boomerang blade.
Doesn't seem much is gonna really happen. I mean, everyone is pretty low. Everyone wants to back. Looks like Equilibrium want to keep this push going though. But you saw the beauty of Janna in that last fight. Her ult and that beautifully timed Q, the tornado, to deny the Lee Sin Q coming in. It was played beautifully, and it just shows the strength of Janna in this game.
Yeah, I think they want to stick around to look for a fight because Dragon is now spawning in less than 30 seconds, so make sure people can get saw this out. Oh, the charm does land on the toe grinder. He does use Haste Shield to try and jump away to safety. Like, they're quite unsure on what they want to do. Boosh is recalling. There's 10 seconds to Dragon. They're quite low as well. I don't know if they're going to be looking to start Dragon, but it's quite risky for either side to do anything just yet now. But looks like Equilibrium not going to give up the push just yet. They're still looking to get this wave right in, but it's difficult as well because there's quite a bit of wave clear on the side of Unite as well. Just trying to build that pressure. They are going to make their way towards that Dragon, it seems. But I don't know if it's going to be such a good idea.
We saw the battle of wills, like who's gonna back first, who's gonna stop pushing, and looks like Equilibrium decide to just move on to the Dragon because, as you said, both teams have a lot of wave play in the form of Ahri, Corki, oh.
Yeah,
they just
like that the Knagash Razor goes right into the ultimate as well, hook off to the focus down, he's quite low, has a double wave, double kill for Razor and a kill for Enlim as well. It looks like the flash is gonna be used Nevermore over the wall, and that was basically a repetition of last time as well. Equilibrium being too antsy to start that Dragon, kind of paying the price for it as well, but Unite are going to be able to pull this right out of the Dragon pit and go right for it because there's nobody ready to contest. There is Nevermore on the side of Don't Know. Looks like he's trying to focus Razor, but sticking around the sides, the Damien Boosh does use the ultimate, go right for Dalga. The Dragon is picked up, and that was just overstaying alongside Nevermore. Sticking alongside Nevermore. It was a really bad decision by Equilibrium.
Yeah, I'm not too sure why Nevermore and Dalga were actually staying. I mean, their only chances of taking that Dragon is hoping that Razor doesn't smite it or they kill Razor and then hope to steal it that way. However, they Unite had the whole team there and it was only two of Equilibrium. They were just watching them take that Dragon, and whilst all that, like, spent most of that time watching, they could have been doing something. For example, they could have pushed up bot lane and then just backed just to create what little pressure they could. I mean, they had Unite's top lane actually pushing slowly into Equilibrium's top lane, and that was just because of the store of happening in their bot side.
Yeah, so that is two Dragons to Unite now. Looks like they have total Dragon control. The charm does land on Deception and the Firefox goes right into the Spirit Rush as well. The chain does land. One more auto attack will be the kill pickup for Enlimit. Did a great job for himself. He does have that Athens and a Blasting Wand, so he's got a good bit of magic resist and CD and AP going on for himself. Same with Nevermore, that Morello Namakon, which is probably built now on Blanc first.
Interesting to see that Men managed to pick up the Athens first. That's probably due to the fact that he was behind from that first kill. And also is because of the LeBlanc, and she kind of needs that the magic resist against the LeBlanc just so she's a bit more tankier and she doesn't get destroyed in one burst rotation from the LeBlanc.
Yeah. Mr. Arch taking quite a bit of damage. Razor just jumps right in, doesn't even spare soul. Takes that kill for himself. Roaming quite nicely as well, engaging at the correct moment, so this tower pickup as well for Knight. And looks like they might be looking to get another as well. Here's Toe Grinder. Does use a cripple, but can't really do anything. Razor's along the side as well, they're just creating pressure. Trying to let the wave do damage to the tower. Should be able to pick this up shortly enough. It's getting chunked down for a bit. Evermore looks like they're trying to join him as well, but Enlimit gonna follow him down and join his team, so for now, it looks like they're just trying to create some pressure. Nothing really Equilibrium can do. They're gonna have to give up this tier 1 tower in the bot lane.
And that's precisely what they have to do. Looking at the gold leads, and even the the gold lead itself is Unite with a 5k gold lead ahead of Equilibrium. And you can see from the items alone, I mean, Corki has that first item, the Triforce, and it's 20 minutes. He has his power spike. He has his item spike, and he has an extra BF sword on top of that Triforce. Whereas the opposing bot lane, Mr. Irish on Sivir, only has that unfinished Infinity Edge, and looks like there's a gank in the bot lane.
Yeah, so let's use a Sonic Wave. Nice timing by Coke Pops with the Monsoon. Looks like he's going to be focused down. Coke's going to have to be really careful. The Sonic Wave lands yet again, but it's not going to follow that up. It's under the safety of the tower. Nevermore here as well. But that leaves Enlimit there in the mid lane to push freely and to let that wave push into the tier 2 tower. So, looks like Equilibrium are trying to get something, but in return they don't. But it looks like Unite end up getting something instead of them. And, the amount of damage coming out from that missile barrage and Corki, as you said, that Triforce and BF Sword doing a lot of damage.
And this is when Unite want to be pushing their lead that they have. They want to be going for every objective that they can be. Towers are going down, as you can see. All the outer towers of Equilibrium are now down. And it's up to Unite now to control these deep vision within Equilibrium Stronghold just to create that extra pressure and to snowball their lead further on.
Yeah, they just picked up that last outer turret, and Equilibrium haven't gotten a single tower for themselves, and they haven't gotten a dragon either, so they're really struggling to pick up objectives. All the really bad situation, Mr. Irish doesn't pop that spell shield, doesn't really do much for him. That's a kill for Unite Hush. They're gonna look like to chase down Annie, but she's gonna get away to safety. They're really squishy as well and really behind in levels, so it makes it even harder to deal with that Tien Jana. And Razor's been everywhere, been to the top lane, mid lane, and bot lane. Has a lot of pressure, but the ultimate being used by Boost just to get to the top lane pretty fast to try and defend that tower. Will he be able to is the question. Thalker is just gonna completely ignore him and focus that tower anyways. So that's that for himself as the first tower for Equilibrium. Helps them with their gold, a global gold a bit anyways.
And they're both in the top lane, they just choose to ignore each other. I mean, this is the power of Cho'Gath and I guess Sion as well. These bruisers who just, they just tickle each other. It would take far too long and too much effort to even try and make solo kills in that top lane. But we see both junglers both picking up the warrior enchant. However, Xin does have that lead in terms of items with all the gold differentials in the form of the towers and the kills and assists. And it really shows which jungler had the most presence in the early game.
Yeah, and his 4-1-3 did a lot for his team as well and helped to secure those dragons. And so it's making it difficult for Lee Sin to really do anything. He's attempted many counter ganks, but it just hasn't worked out for them, unfortunately for them. But let's see, nothing really too huge coming out just now. I think Equilibrium probably going to be focusing to try and get some more objectives for themselves. Dragon has now spawned, so this is a big thing for Equilibrium at the moment. They have lost out in two dragons, and Unite are not going to hesitate. They're just to start that dragon immediately and try and zone out Equilibrium.
And they do not want to give this third dragon stack up. I mean, that first stack and dragon, given the plus 5% on the movement speed, that is a lot. In terms, if you can apply that and give it a gold value.
Ooh, there goes the ultimate and the misses, so they're gonna focus Annie down first. White Zoe, Knight Hush picks that kill for himself. He's focused on the Toad Rider. He's trying to focus Hush, but unfortunately, it's the working Dalker that's standing alongside Sivir. But it's madly a chunk count for so much. That is a 4-for-1 trade in favor of Unite. And they get the dragon on top of that as well. Clearly, a lot stronger than Equilibrium at the moment, and Equilibrium are really struggling to even contest these objectives.
Yeah, and that's a problem. I mean, especially in Equilibrium, you can't give them an extra dragon, but even if you fight for it, you're at a disadvantage just in terms of items. I mean, Unite are a lot stronger. I mean, what can you do about it? They have to try and make picks. They have to try and use their comp with the LeBlanc bursting one target, with Lee Sin possibly in second someone into the team so they can just one-shot them. And with the Annie, the stun. So it's really difficult, especially with the Annie, because she wants to be flashing in Tibbers, trying to get a 5-man stun. However, with that, they don't really have the damage to follow up.
Yeah. And now Hush left alone that bot lane to chuck away the tier 2 tower, almost taking it down, because Hush gonna have to back off because there's now 3 people here in the bot lane. And that shut down for Nevermore onto Enlimit. Code Grinder Cloud in a pretty sticky situation. Does use the Dragon's Rage Ignite ticking down, but looks like he's gonna escape. He's under his tower now. And it's just Unite being all over the place now. They're just roaming from place to place. Dalker caught out now as well. He has to use the Branduin's trying to escape, slowing him down a bit. But Flash gonna use that missile barrage now. Razor jumps right in onto him. It's a flash. There is Annie along the side, but can't really help, so he tries to juke them out a little bit. He's just gonna walk away. But it's a huge time, so it's gonna take him a while to take him down. Eventually, he does, and the kill goes to Hustlin, so. Well, Hush now. So he's 607. He's got a Bloodthirst and a Triforce, doing incredible amounts of damage. It's really difficult for Equilibrium to deal with.
Yeah, and that's not a good time for someone to be caught out like that. I mean, they take this tower, and they could, like, they have a huge wave top lane. They could just even rotate top side. Looks like they're deciding on taking little objectives, taking little camps away, trying to make a little pick in the mid lane.
Yeah, taking every little tiny thing, camps, and things like that makes it even harder for the opposing team to deal with. So they're really struggling. They can't even go to their own jungle without being in the danger. And that's a nice ward hop by Togran to get safety. But yet again, they can't even stick around their own jungle. Now they're just gonna go towards that bot lane. The tower's quite low. It's gonna fall pretty soon. Razor jumps right on to do a lot of damage. It's done used by Annie, but she gets charmed. That's two kills for Unlimit. Now there's only three people left on Equilibrium to try and defend this inhibitor turret. Don't think they'll be able to. They're gonna have to back off. There's just too much damage coming out. It does use the distortion for a little bit of damage, but again, it's really hard. Focus down that tower. And this one goes in, Togrinder. And knocked back by the monsoon. Has to use that warhammer to try and get away. Again, Unite just building a lot of pressure. They should be able to get this down, and they do. I'm gonna back off. Not gonna focus that inhibitor. Two members of Equilibrium have respawned.
And I really like these items, how Unite itemized, especially Razor picking up mainly MR items with that Banshees and with that Hexdrinker. I mean, looking at the team composition of Equilibrium, they have Cho'Gath in the top lane, LeBlanc in the mid lane, and Annie support. I mean, that's three fairly high damage, high magic damage champions, and the only AD damage they have to really worry about is the Sivir. I mean, the Lee Sin is going pretty much rather full tank at the moment, aside from the jungle item and the warrior enchant. And also, I'd like to point out Hush's build, going for that Bloodthirster after the Triforce, and that's just to deny the one-shot potential from LeBlanc. I mean, if Hush stays alive in these teamfights, it's really difficult for Unite to lose any fights. Because he has that Triforce. I mean, if they're sieging, they can just use the Triforce procs in that tower, and it does so much damage. And even in teamfights in general, that as long as Hush stays alive, he's going to be constantly dishing out that damage, and there's a lot of bursts coming out from Unite.
Yeah, and it's really hard for Equilibrium to even target him. He's got Boosh in the front line as well. He's a huge tank, and the Valkyrie as well that comes out from Hush. Just gives him that little bit of escapability as well, and he does a lot of damage from a distance from those missile barrages, so it's gonna be really hard to focus him down. Togrinder has tried to before, but it's just not worked out for him at all. And now Zalker is in a bad situation. Razor's gonna jump right onto him, and there's Emlyn as well to help him out a little bit, but since he is a tank, it's gonna take a while for him to get him down. They're gonna keep focusing down. There's now five members around him, and eventually he falls to Boosh. And just now, looks like Equilibrium making mistake after mistake, just getting caught out in the jungle. They've got no vision around the area. Now Annie in a pretty bad situation. They even had to flash the boss script bomb here. The ultimate by Boosh hits into both of them, and now the Spirit Rush being used as well. The Orb of Deception doing a lot of damage. That will be Unlimit picking up a kill, and now Nevermore here under the tower. It does land that chain, but won't connect really exactly. Prime misses as well. Oh, extremely low, and almost gets Nevermore, but that's going to be another inhibitor turret here for Unite. They are absolutely really strong right now at the moment. It's really hard for Equilibrium to do anything. Nevermore won't do much. They'll get the inhibitor for themselves. They're going to back off. Because, again, it is quite early in the game. It's mid-game now, 30 minutes, but the count, respawn timers aren't that high just yet. But it looks like Nevermore wants something, but he has to be careful because Unlimit does quite a bit of damage, especially now with that Abyssal Scepter.
And that death cap as well. And it looks like they're setting up. Oh, no, it looks like they're going back. And let's see whether Unite decide to go for that Baron or even possibly the Dragon. I mean, with that top inhibitor down, there's a lot of pressure in the top side just building up the longer Equilibrium ignore that. So I'd like to see a Dragon because that 4th stack with the extra damage would provide a lot. And With it being mid-game now, with all the items that Unite have on their side, that extra damage percentage, especially from the dragon buff, will equate to a lot. And yeah, it looks like they are going for that dragon.
Yeah, they're not hesitant at all. And Equilibrium realize that they can't really do much to contest this either. They're trapped in their own jungle. And they're going to just start that away. They don't even need everybody to help them out. Toadfinder is trying to calm down. Maybe try for a steal, but we've seen that before. It's really not a good idea to jump in between all the members of... Oh, tries to, but he gets in there way too late and ends up losing his life right in the end. It was a bit too... kind of a big misplay there by Toadfinder. It wasn't worth that. And there's surrender vote, actually, by Equilibrium. So it's going to be the first game of this two-game series going to Unite. GG, well played to them. And there will be a second game coming up quite shortly, so... We'll be going to that quite soon, but we're going to go on a break first, so see you guys soon. We'll be right back. guys, and welcome back to game 2 of the G-Series League of Legends tournament. We have Unite versus Equilibrium, and Unite took the first win of this best of 2 series, and this is the last game for both teams against each other. So we'll see, will Equilibrium be able to take the win this time around, or will Unite become victorious with 2-0? And first banned there by Equilibrium is going to be Xerath, and we did see that in the previous game.
Mm-hmm. And like we was talking about before, it's just another champion which no one really wants to deal with that wave clear and the gnar ban again. So these are pretty much seeing the same bans as the previous game. However, I want to highlight what Equilibrium do regarding that Janna pick from Unite. I mean, Cocoa Puffs from the previous games I've seen as fresh, and today I've seen as Janna. He played extremely low well, and those are the strengths of Janna. Lee Sin could not get into the fight. Even if he wanted to insect, there was Cocoa Puffs ready to Monsoon that pushes the Lee Sin away, and even if Lee Sin lands a Q, he can just Tornado, and it just completely shut Lee Sin down within the mid and late game.
Yeah, Cocoa Puffs had a fantastic game on Janna. He played it really well. It was precise and exactly timed. So you can really see the strengths with him on Janna. But instead, they actually decided to ban out that Corki. Now, Hush did have a great game on Corki, but I don't know, like, you tend to ban somebody who was the strongest in a previous game we played, but the reason was due to the impact that his teammates had around him as well. Like, Cocoa Puffs had a fantastic impact, great impact as well. He roamed a lot in the previous game. So they did get rid of that Corki, though it's quite debatable if it should have been banned out. Jarvan gonna be the final ban for them, and Azir gonna be that second ban for Unite, and we'll just see what the third one's gonna be.
Seems like they replaced that Corki with the Graves, so there could be a possible Graves pickup for Unite. And as you were mentioned, it depends on which jungler had the impact, and we saw how much impact Razor had, especially in the early game on that Xin Zhao. Not so much from Toe Grinders, Lee Sin, unfortunately. However, we'll see what he can do differently, and which junglers both sides pick up. Kha'Zix is still open as well, and we know how well Razor plays Kha'Zix.
Yeah, so Graves gonna be that final ban by Unite, so they're playing it smartly. Didn't want to hand that over if they can't even have it themselves. So that's 2 AD carries been taken down, 2 strongest AD carries as well. So Dahlgreen being first pick, we'll see what he decides to pick up for his team. They take away the Sion from Boosh. Now that's interesting.
And the Sion pick, like, it's almost like a double-edged sword. I mean, one is good in terms of he's taken away from Boosh, who we all know loves playing that Sion and plays it very well. However, on the other hand, like, if you don't play that as well as the opposing top laner who you're trying to pick it away from, I mean, Boosh knows the inside and outsides of Sion. It is his champion, pretty much. So Booker is pressured into pretty much performing very well, especially against Boosh's main champion, pretty much.
Yeah, so there is that pressure, as you said. So let's see. He's not going for the Cho'Gath this time around. He did do fine in that top lane. He didn't struggle at all, really. He did lose out to a couple of ganks, but he still did fine on Cho'Gath. It was just kind of later into the mid game where they started losing out. But Razor is hovering over that Kha'Zix, so it looks like he's going to be taking that up for the jungle, and Boosh going to lock in that Rek'Sai for the top lane.
Rek'Sai in the top lane, and I've actually seen this a lot, and I really like it, especially in terms of the global presence it has. For example, with that TP, the Rek'Sai can TP behind the enemy bot lane, get a gank that way, and then if they get something from him, or even if they don't, he has his ultimate and he can just ult back into the top lane, and he loses out on very few minions, so he doesn't lose out on much XP or gold in terms of lasting. So I really like that Rek'Sai pick in the top lane. But I'm probably assuming it's going to be a rather tanky build for that Rek'Sai, especially with Razor on that Kha'Zix. But it all depends on whether Razor's Kha'Zix goes tanky or more damage orientated.
Yeah, Razor does tend to go for that more damage oriented Kha'Zix build, because it has more of an impact when it comes to ganks as well. But he does build a tanky item or two, especially like something like Ranjuan's, which he needs. But looking over to Equilibrium, they decide to lock in that Janna and Kalista. It's the first time we've seen her play in this G-Series tournament. There only really has been 2 sets of series, so that's gonna be interesting to see how he performs on that. I haven't seen many people really trying to practice on Kalista or main Kalista. And like with it won't be Toe Grinder. It will actually be Taylor Swift on Janna. But that's picked up for their team anyways, and looks like Cocoa Puffs won't have this time around.
And the Jarnet goes to Equilibrium this time, so let's see how that plays out. But an interesting pickup is the Callista. Recent news has noted that Callista, in terms of solo queue, has been very strong, and it feels like players have finally figured out her strengths and weaknesses. I mean, we've seen Callista's pickup in that Hurricane, which actually procs on her Ren, for example. She can auto-attack, and she could apply her W to 3 different champions in 1 auto attack, and that's almost like the Kale with the Hurricane. That's really strong, so this will be really interesting to see how it plays out. And with that Janna, you can just babysit her in lane as well.
Yeah, and Tosh kind of going back to one of his old school AD carries with that Caitlyn, and Cocopop's taking gonna be taking that Nami, so that works really well with Caitlyn. Caitlyn, nicely long ranged AD carry, and especially someone like Nami, it provides a lot of poke in lane as well, so that does a great job for them. So we'll see how bot lane works this time around when they're playing 2 different champions to the previous game. And the final 2 picks for Equilibrium are going to be Karthus and Jin Zhao.
Karthus in the mid lane, I'm assuming. Ooh, you don't see it as much often, however it really depends on the player. I mean, in the early game there's not much happening, especially with Karthus. He's just going to be farming, maybe getting a few trades in with the Q, the very safe Q actually. However, a LeBlanc pickup would be really good to play against that Karthus with the mobility from LeBlanc. There's again really difficult to gank that LeBlanc, and if plays are made, she can easily outplay the Karthus regarding that distortion. Like, as soon as Karthus tries to Q, she just W's in, the Q misses, and she wins on the out on the trade.
Yeah,
but Karthus is mainly going to focus on farming, so let's see what Endlimit can actually do.
Yeah. So that's pretty interesting as well. And I think Karthus tends to struggle a little bit against someone as hyper-aggressive as a LeBlanc. He's really mainly about that farming and hitting level 6 with that bit of global damage as well from his ultimate. So just looking at the lane matchups now, it is now Delker going to be playing Sion in that top lane, and it's going to be Boosh on the Rek'Sai. So laning phase, how's that going to go?
Laning phase, there's going to be enough poke from both sides. Rek'Sai does have that built-in sustain with that rage bot every time she goes into burrowing. And with that CC, I mean, Sion is rather immobile, so it would be fairly easy for actually Rek'Sai to set up the ganks for the Kha'Zix. And I mean, all he has to do is get into melee range with the Sion, burrow, and then unburrow, and there's a knock-up already. And then it'll be really difficult for that Sion to get away.
Yeah, and Toegrinder now playing Jin Zhao on now in this time around instead of Razor. So it'll be interesting to see, he's not playing Lee Sin, and he's playing something different. Maybe he might have better performance, might be more comfortable with it as well. And Razor, we know he loves playing Kha'Zix, one of his top played champions as well. So we definitely know how comfortable he is on it. And just knowing Kha'Zix in general, early levels, looking to farm it out, and then level 6, great for ganking.
And it's going to be really interesting to see which lanes Toegrinder is going to be focusing on with that Zin. I mean, we saw Razor and his really good game knowledge in terms of jungling and which lanes he could gank. Like, he tended to avoid the mid lane because it's LeBlanc, and we all know how hard it is to gank a LeBlanc. So he made most of his focus in the bot lane, especially after that very first kill in the bot lane with the counter gank. And from that, he can just keep snowballing and keep coming back. And with that Sivir and Nani, they're both fairly immobile champions. They're just pretty much easy kills once those summoners are down or once the spell shield is down.
Yeah, and Callista, Janna versus Caitlyn, Nami. And we see Hush and Cocopops have played this duo bot lane quite a lot. Hush likes to play Caitlyn. He played it a lot in the previous seasons as well. Kind of moved to the more stronger AD carries, obviously, as they grew stronger within the meta. But he's going back to one of his standard AD carries. And Cocopop's playing Nami. Now, what Nami's really all about is landing that Aqua Prison for those engages and how well you can do that in the laning phase as well. So if Cocopop manages to do that, that will be great for them, and that will help them really dominate that bot lane. But now Callista and Janna, that's pretty strong bot lane as well. So maybe Hush and Cocopops haven't had much experience against this specific duo, so it could be a bit difficult for them as well.
Mm-hmm. And once Callista gets going, especially because I say her early game isn't as strong, so her strengths really show when it comes to the mid and late game. And with that Janna is always a good safe pick with, and it looks like Taylor Swift is actually taking that exhaust rather than ignite as seen by Coco Puffs in the last game as Janna. So it looks like Equilibrium's bot lane are going to play a more safe farming style. They just want to protect the Kalista, get her through the early game, and then hope she shines in mid and late game with enough farm, maybe picking up some kills here and there. But with that Caitlyn and Nami, it's going to be very difficult. And again, Coco Pups taking the ignite on that Nami. And it's going to be very difficult for Equilibrium's bot lane to survive this, I'd say, because of Unite's sustain with the Nami and the very early game poke and trades from that Caitlyn, who has immense range.
Yeah, I expect this bot lane to be pretty aggressive during those early levels, and as we always say, it's about that level 2 as well, and who hits it first and who takes advantage of it as well. And both of them have pretty good level 2 initiation as well, so they have a lot of poke as well from both bot lanes, so it'll be interesting to see how these two play it out. Now, Unite did take the first win of this series. Let's see how Equilibrium bring it back. They are playing different champions all around, so maybe they might have a better performance. And they did fine in the early game, but it was just kind of around when Dragon hit that kind of went downhill for them. So now onto the Rift, and we should be heading into the jungle for these teams. The last game, it looked like Equilibrium were looking to invade Unite the jungle, but they got spotted out. So let's see, is it gonna be the same this time around, or are they just gonna stick around their own jungle?
And we'll see whether they invade. I mean, last time Equilibrium tried to perform that invade, especially in the bot lane, they got spotted out, by that Tribush ward. And early wards coming out from Equilibrium. It looks like it's a standard fan, and they're playing very defensive wards for any possible invades from the Unite. But it looks like a standard, just both teams just want to spread out, get some wards down. No one wants to play a bit too aggressive.
Yeah, they're just warding alongside the river, just get clear vision to the entrances of their jungle, and no team's really looking for that invade, as you said. They're just going to play it safe, and it's probably the best decision to make as well, because especially with all the changes that are occurring all the time, it's harder for the junglers as well. If they lose out a bit in those early levels, it becomes harder and harder for them throughout the game. So they want to get their jungle going as fast as possible, as best as possible during those early levels. So it looks like both junglers are actually going to start off the top side of the jungle.
And we can see it looks like both bot lanes want to take that level 1 camp. And Kalista and Janna were very good at actually doing it with. We can see Mr. Arz there placing that ward just in case Unite's bot lane try and come in and do a little bit of a cheese and prevent them from doing that level 1 camp.
Yeah, so they're both gonna, as you said, take that level 1 camp. So they're gonna be rushing towards that bot lane as well, and be interesting who hits level 2 first as well. Who will have that advantage over one another. So pretty standard starts for everybody. Looking to farm for now, no super aggression, and Limit decides to go in with some distortion and a couple of auto attacks as well, but he takes a bit of creep damage as well, so they end up trading evenly with one another. Gotta be careful of that as well. I know LeBlanc is really all about that aggression. You want to be careful at the same time as well, not take too much creep damage. But Hush looking to get as many auto attacks down as he can. Distortion goes in, still doing a lot of damage. As you said in the previous game, that LeBlanc is really good with that early level damage.
What I really want to highlight is Boosh on that Rek side, taking the Wraiths at level 1 and then teleporting back into lane with that level 2 and health potion advantage. And that's going to put a lot of pressure on Dalka's Sion in that top lane. I mean, yeah. We saw he's already ahead in farm from taking that count. He's a teleport down, however, the advantages he gained is XP, the health potion, so he's going to have a lot more sustain. And he's also a level ahead of that Sion.
Yeah, looks like Valkyr's a bit under pressure as well, because he's taking a lot of damage, and now he's kind of forced to farm under his tower, making him lose XP and a bit of CS as well at the same time. And looking at all the lanes, it looks like Unite are really dominating them. They're really taking it to their advantage, especially the champions they're playing as well, just to zone the opponents out and to just try and keep their farm going. And Because you can tell that Unite's, the champions that they're playing at the moment, they do have that early level advantage over Equilibriums. So they're not hesitating to do as much as they possibly can so early in the game.
Yeah, and we've seen like this sort of game, especially from Worlds, with Samson White's game against... it's actually game one, Samson White against Royal Club. Royal Club picked three laners, which were getting shoved in constantly because Samson White picked.
Oh, and it needs to be careful. It's getting really aggressive. Didn't land those chains, so ended up taking a lot of tower shots as well. So quite evenly going another, but decided to go on Hush. Mr. Irish quite low. Here is Toadline in the volley, decides to jump in onto Hush, but he's gonna focus down Mr. Irish. First blood goes to him. Coco Pops really wants this kill, but he has to back off because of the flash. I'm gonna try and chase him down. Red Buff slowing down, gets knocked up as well at the same time. Don't think he'll be able to make it out alive. And that is two kills for that Equilibrium, one on the jungler and one on the AD carry.
Unfortunately, Razor couldn't or wasn't there in time for that counter game. I was going to say, actually, when all your lanes are pushing up because they have strong early laners, it's up to the jungler now to only really have to farm up, and he only needs to counter gank because it. Like, when lanes are so pushed, it's really difficult to gank a lane like that unless you lane gank. However, from what we've seen from Dandy and that Rengar, he just plays that counter ganking jungler, especially when all these lanes are ahead. And yeah. The jungler can, I mean, Togekiss can only help one lane at a time, so with that jungler popping up in that bot lane, it's up to Razor to really make plays around that. However, Equilibrium did get what they want. They got that double kill for the bot lane, so that's the Kalista getting a gold advantage, and however she is down in CS, but that really does help her in the early game where she's the most weakest.
Yeah, and Ogre trying to show some aggression onto Boosh. We saw this in the previous game as well, they just have these constant back and forths. Cookbox gonna go towards that bush, but he gets caught out there by Toadgrinder. He's doing a lot of damage, only level 3 as well, misses the Aqua Prison. He's trying to escape, but will fall eventually. Hush in the meantime was trying to focus down Janna, but unfortunately he did not get anything in return.
Yeah, I mean, that bot lane, they were pushed off pretty far ahead despite having no wards, but unfortunately when they decided to ward, out comes a Zin into the face. That's another kill going over to Toadgrinder, sorry.
Yeah, and you can see he's playing a lot more comfortably as well on that Zhao. He's doing a lot of better job. He tried to do as much as possibly could on that Lee Sin the previous game, but you can definitely see it's working out better for him on this champion because he's making a lot of good ganks as well and roaming quite a bit. But Razor, we haven't seen much presence from him at all yet so far. It's almost 7 minutes into the game. I'm pretty sure he's probably looking for that level 6 before he does anything. But in the meantime, it looks like Unite bot lane anyways having a bit of a difficult time now.
And well, you can see the Kha'Zix with no kills or assists currently, whilst Toadgrinder and that Xin Zhao has 2 kills and 1 assist. So the early impact from Toadgrinder has been more influential this game. And this could be what Equilibrium need to get even in terms of game or wins in this series, because as we were saying, Unite's strengths are in the early game.
Yeah, it's been used there by Boosh. Just get back into the top lane pretty fast. And you can see Nevermore, he's taking a lot of harass from Enlimit, but he's trading back nicely as well, so he's not panicking whenever, which you tend to see most of the time with against LeBlancs. Tend to panic when they use that distortion in, but he's playing it quite nicely, so they're trading evenly with one another. He does get that blue buff now as well to help him farm a bit better. He does have his tier stacking as well at the same time. But definitely Equilibrium doing pretty well this time around. This game, and then it goes right in, has a lot of damage, has a flash, still gets chained down, does use the wall pain to try and get something. But here is Toadgrinder, who might be able to, oh, but yeah, he used that smite to pick up that kill. Himself to trade one for one. Top lane as well, there's a bit of aggression. Not really gonna get anything from that. Hush and Coke Pops is focused in that bot lane to try and get that tower there, chunking it down for a bit, creating a lot of pressure. against Mr. Irish and Taylor Swift.
And Togryne picking up yet another kill. Nevermore did have that ult. I'm not sure whether or not it would have killed the LeBlanc, whether or not it had enough damage. However, there is that Karthus ult still available, so that's a lot of pressure on Unite's lanes. For example, if a fight breaks out, they have to be cautious of that Karthus ult.
Yeah, and as you said, a fight to break out. Looks like there was a bit of a skirmish going on that bot lane. Zalkir here in the top lane, take a lot of damage there by Boosh. He has to be really careful. Really trying to freeze the lane as well to his favor, but again, Nevermore taking a lot of damage. Lucky the chain didn't connect, else that would have been him dead yet again. He's just trying to farm. He flashes right in. Distortion doing a lot of damage. Another kill there for Enlimit, and this is what we see, especially someone like LeBlanc against a Karthus who has just so much more burst damage and a lot of mobility as well.
Definitely. And also, with what we were saying about the early strengths of Unite, it seems to have only really shown in the mid lane, and this game almost now relies on LeBlanc be making those picks, especially when it's coming into the mid game now. And Razor, unfortunately, still with zero kills or assists. And I'm still curious to see whether Boosh on that Rek'Sai uses that teleport, maybe in the bot lane, to set up to relieve some pressure for that Caitlyn and Nami. However, there aren't any deep wards in that bot lane, so it's really difficult for Boosh to come in.
Yeah, yet again, Nevermore takes quite a bit of damage, and it's pretty dangerous for him to sit around his tower. There is Razor lurking around the side as well, and Togryne is going to walk right into him. He takes a lot of damage. His enemy is when he has to use the ultimate, and he flashes away as well. This mana quite low. He uses this might as well to slow Enlimit down. Nevermore there trying to put down as much damage as he can. Good job, but here is Boosh to join the fight. Comes right in onto Razor. Gets himself a kill. Enlimit in a lot of trouble now as well. That is a kill for both Dalker and Nevermore. I think I just said Boosh for that fight because I'm so used to him on Zion. Sorry, it was Dalker. My bad. I apologize.
Everyone makes mistakes. But, more kills going over to Equilibrium. This looks like their game. And yeah. Reaction. Actually, no, this is Equilibrium taking that dragon, actually. With that Glister, it's very easy to take with that Ren stacking up. And no contestation. Looks like they get out for free.
Yeah, and the roles really reversed from the last game as well. We saw Razor have such a huge impact when he played Xin Zhao in that previous game. He was roaming quite a bit and he got a lot of ganks, but this time Togryne is doing that for his team. That's exactly what they needed as well. Unfortunately for him, it didn't work out for him on Lee Sin in the first game, but he's definitely doing a great job now. In this game, he has 100% kill participation so far, so he's doing a great job. And yet, Razor still looking for an opportunity to make an impact in the game, but it just seems like he can't find one. Because all the lanes are pushed up so far, he doesn't know which lane to gank exactly.
And it's a shame because what we were saying about Rek'Sai's strengths, especially in the top lane, well, first of all, he's built a Blade of the Rune King first, so I'm presuming he's gonna play more split bush style. He's gonna go for that 1v1 pressure whilst Dalker and that Sion is building tanky.
Yeah, and Limit got caught out here in the mid lane again. He does use the distortion. The Requiem is being used. Will be enough. It will be. And that is a kill now for Nevermore in that mid lane. So, as we were just talking about, Togryne doing a fantastic job. Now they're gonna push in this tier 1 tower in the mid lane. Oh, but here comes the tidal wave from the Coco Pops. He uses that Aquapism as well. He has Razor now to do something. And shield being used onto. Nevermore, but Togryne taking quite low as well. He's gonna try and focus Hush, but that's another auto attack. A double kill there for Hush, so a trade 2-for-2 in the end.
Mm-hmm. And that top tower, that bot tower, sorry, did go down, which allows Unite's bot lane, Hush and Coco Pops, to roam. And good job they did because they picked up that nice double kill in the mid lane. Racer, unfortunately, does go down again. However, they get a lot of damage on this mid lane with no follow up from Equilibrium. Because, well, from Jonna trying to solo defend this mid tower. However, Kalista is picking up that farm in the long lane.
Yeah, trying to get that solo farm, solo XP, but Enlimit is standing along the side, probably looking for some form of initiation. Looks like Hush and Coco Pops taking this tower. They have just a little bit of moves to push, but now Nevermore has reached the mid lane, so that tower is going to stay alive for a little while longer. Looks like they're all just trying to group around the area, but as you said, with that Blade of the Rune King, it definitely looks like Lush is going to be split pushing that top lane, and he does almost have that teleport available to help his team if a fight occurs.
And now it's really up to, because most of the kills right now are in from Equilibrium's side are actually on Zin, on Tonegrinder, and it's up to him to really be making the plays around the map. I mean, it would have been nice for Nevermore to pick up some of those kills, for example, on that first LeBlanc kill, when he could have ulted. That was a flash gun from Nevermore.
Yeah, and as mobile he is, oh, but he takes a lot of damage. Aisha has to back up, how to use that heal is, sorry, no, he didn't use the heal, but he's taking a lot of damage there from Karthus, and that is the power of Karthus. You sit there and you farm, build your items, and you can do damage from the distance, especially with that Requiem. So, 3 versus 2 here in the mid lane, they're just gonna farm that out constantly because they really can't push the top lane. Bush decides to go in onto Belker yet again, doing so much damage with only that Blade of the Rune King.
I really want to point out Unite's immense control in terms of vision. I mean, they're behind in kills, however they aren't behind in gold. They are actually almost 2k ahead in gold, but you just look at the difference in terms of vision. I mean, I can't even count a single ward from Equilibrium being out right now, whilst on the other hand, Unite's warding, especially on the top side, is so deep. I mean, they can just lose a fight right now again.
Yeah, the Tidal Wave has been used Monsoon there by Taylor Swift. Well, Pain Razor doing a lot of damage as well. Looks like he's going to be focused and jumped in on by Toegrinder. He gets a kill for himself. That's a 1-for-1 trade so far. Hush trying to focus down somebody, but oh, double kill. Or Nevermore, he's doing a lot of damage, and unfortunately Pokepops could do anything to help because he had no mana available.
Yeah,
and looks like they're gonna push.
And looks like they're trying to get this kill on the Nami. Looks like Karthus runs out of mana, unfortunately, with a TP coming in the mid lane.
Yeah, Lush here in the mid lane, gonna target Nevermore first, and now here is Unlimit to join him. We'll focus down Taylor Swift, and then that is enough to get that kill. Here's Delta to join Mr. Irish. So that is 2 kills there for Unite. So they're slowly and steadily catching up those kills, and they still do have more gold due to their objectives. But here's Togren yet again. The action doesn't end. Hold on to Unlimit. Tries to walk away. Mr. Irish gonna try and chase him down. Here is Razor back with the team. Gets 1 kill, and now Togren is taking a lot of damage. Valker unfortunately can't do anything. Here is the Requiem. Unfortunately for Unlimit, does end up falling to that. So, yet again, more kills for Unite, and they're going to be able to pick up this tower now as well in the mid lane.
And it looks like Unlimit miscalculated or just forgot about that Karthus ult. I mean, he should have probably bagged as soon as Karthus went down. I mean, as soon as he comes back up with that respawn, he's going to have that item purchase with more AP, and that ult is going to do a lot more damage. So that's an unfortunate kill going over. However, they look like Unite get another tower in the mid lane, which is going to give them a huge advantage in terms of vision control. And what I like to see, and what Unite did, is after they take that tower, they ward in the mid lane, so now they can replace that tower, which just went down, with vision of their own. Now it spots anyone running from mid lane into their own jungles, whether it be Equilibrium going in the top side or bot side jungle. And Rex, Bush on that Rex side has pretty much all the control in that top side with those tunnels and with that ward.
Yeah, and in the mid lane, there was a bit of a gauge going out. Ryzen decides to jump onto Toegrinder, use the ultimate ace in the hole being used as well. The Toegrinder is really low, and it was a very smart idea there by Unite. Focus down Toegrinder so they could try and go for this dragon, which they are going to do. So they're going to start this out. Toegrinder is really low, so no, he can try and attempt to steal, but looks like Equilibrium are coming around the side, but this dragon is going out really fast, which does get taken by Unite. The fight begins. Knock up there used by Janna. Nice aqua prison as well. They're just going to back off into their own jungle. I feel like they know they can't fight this. They do have the advantage. They got the dragon, and that was more than enough for them.
The steal.
Yeah, the steal of the blue buff. And now that's going to be Equilibrium switching right over to the mid lane. Put himself a tier 1 tower, really bad positioning there by Hodge and Coco Pops, and chased down now by Zelker. Here is Toegrinder focusing down on Bush, doing a lot of damage here with Pops as well. Hush and Cocobox in the jungle. Aqua Prison blocks up Nevermore. They're just gonna try to move to the safety of their tower. So that is a nice there kill for Equilibrium and a tower in the mid lane.
Surprised they didn't defend that ward. I mean, they just dropped it and then ran away from it and allowed Hush to actually pick up that ward, so not too sure whether or why they didn't protect it. But they did pick up a few kills here and there, and that's a problem when Bush builds almost full damage. He had a lot of gold on him, and he hasn't been back in a long time. However, he had that lane but never made use of it. He was just too squishy in that team for a little.
Equilibrium are overstaying. That will try to attempt for Unite to try and get something for himself. They do end up trading one for one ace in the hole on Dedalker. He's quite tanky, so didn't do much. And then if you're able to do the chains, try and lock him down, does pick up a kill for himself. Mr. Irish trying to get away, so that is one for one effectively here in terms of kills. But Unite back off now, not going to really look to push any further. They are quite low. Too risky as well, and Boosh just gonna move right his way back to the top lane.
And it seems like Boosh picked up a Hex Drinker and a Giant Spell. I thought he was gonna remain playing this sort of split push style. I mean, judging by Adalka's item build, he just literally went full tank. He's not gonna be able to stop Boosh if he chooses to split push. So I'm guessing the Hex Drinker tells me that Boosh is going to actually try and play more of a split push and team fighting role. He's going to use his TP for those team fights, even though the strengths of Rek'Sai does say that he should probably be split pushing more.
Yeah, and does get out here in the top lane for overstaying the vocal wall, but here is Janna slowing down, not getting up anywhere. That would be a kill there for Janna in the end. So Boosh looks like wants to split push, but he's making too many mistakes. But here's Raze with a lot of damage. He's just right onto Janna, but it looks like he has to back off because the rest of Equilibrium are over there, and the damage they're onto Mr. Irish thereby and limit. And we'll see now what happens exactly. They're just trying to trade back with one another. They're not looking for a full on fight. I'm gonna chase this down. Cops calling in that brush. Oh, he got spotted out. He's a really sticky situation to walk out of that brush there. And he is going to be in a lot of trouble. Does have to use that tidal wave. Receiving a lot of damage. Nice Aqua Prison to try and get to safety, but he does get slowed in the end. So he used a flash. Here is Razor as well. Gets himself one kill. Has to flash over the wall, but gets flashed in right after. TP used by Booch to try and help his team out a little bit. Booch caught in the middle of everybody. Taking a lot of damage as well. Janna quite low. There goes the ace in the hole on Nevermore. Does pop that monsoon. Boosh really low. Fortunately for him, doesn't get anything out of that. Here's Unlimited. Jumps right in with that distortion. Gets himself a double kill. Now, Cocopops and Hush trying to chase down Dalker. Don't know if this is such a good idea. Don't know if they're going to get much either. Does use the Caliber Net. Has that slow as well. So he's just going to try and walk away. You really want this kill. Aqua Prison does land. This might be enough for them. The Ignite gets popped as well. The shield. Hush really, really looking for this kill, but he might end up paying the price for it, and he does. Really, really greedy for that kill. They end up trading one for one. Still Unite ahead in terms of gold and objectives. There goes the ultimate. I just think that's a really funny ultimate, but just flies from one side of the map to the other, but Boosh just goes back right to the top lane to try and that's the push again.
Yeah, however, I hope this time he doesn't overextend a bit too much, because even though he dragged three or four people stop his split pushing, there was no pressure being built up around the map elsewhere for Unite, so he basically died in vain and nothing really happened. So let's hope he doesn't overextend too much. However, he does have end limit with him behind him to support him this time. But what I really want to know in that last fight was Cocopops. He thought he got caught out, and it turns out to be a crazy bait. I mean, he played really well surviving that and saving the flash for the last moment, and managed to survive bait the whole of Equilibrium into a fight that they don't want.
Yeah, Nevermore getting caught out here as well, taking a lot of damage. Another kill for Boosh. So they're just trying to make picks now, and they're just trying to get as many kills as they possibly can. But so far we've seen this just come back and forth. There hasn't been a real 5 versus 5 and trying to go for an objective. They're just trying to hold. Oh, but here Razor is attempting to steal that red buff and enter himself kill at the same time as well. It's two, actually. Darius gets hit by the tidal wave, big trouble, and they're falling to end limit. So they pick up that red buff as well, and now taking those kills for themselves, they are able to push this tier two tower, in the mid lane and get that for themselves as well. It looks like they might go for that Baron as well. There's a good few seconds left. I wonder if they're gonna go for it or they're gonna back off. Looks like they're making their way towards the area. About 10 seconds left to spawn on Toe Grinder and Mr. Irish. Same for him as well now. So they're gonna start that Baron. Looks like Dalker has an idea that they are doing so, but I don't know if they'll be able to do much to try and prevent this. Pokeball's trying to use the Actros and try and prevent him getting near it. But he walks right into end limit. The Smite is more powerful than the Baron for themselves, and now Dalker in a pretty bad place. End up giving him themselves a kill as well. Nevermore in a rebound position to continue the fight going. Dalker gets himself a kill onto Hush. Toe Grinder, really, really low double kill for Boosh. Try and chase this down even further. Nevermore, next target on the list. Triple kill, Kalista. So getting that kill onto Boosh in the end. And Limit and Coco Pops, the only two people left. They're just gonna back off. And it's now just a 2v2, but happy more worth in favor of Unite getting that Baron buff as well.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, they still have the Baron buff on two members of the team, and it also prevents Equilibrium from picking up. However, it looks like they do try and pick up this dragon as well, and I think they will get it. I mean, Kalista, with those unlimited or the infinite stacks building up from those auto attacks, dragon is no difficult. It's difficult for her to pick it up, I'm sorry. And I mean, Unite have brought this game back into their favor. We saw Razor now, we see Razor's Kha'Zix. I mean, that damage is crazy. And what we saw in the bot side of Equilibrium's junglers, everyone just keeps on getting caught out one by one. I mean, what I like to point out from Equilibrium's side is the lack of vision control. I mean, we saw how everyone just keeps getting caught out one by one, dying, keep going back in, then dying again. And that's what gave Unite the opportunity to take that mid tower and then to take the Baron. So we just want to see a bit more vision control from Equilibrium, because looking at Unite's team comp, they revolve heavily around making catches with that LeBlanc, with that Kha'Zix. So they need to try and avoid that and play to their strengths.
Yeah, I feel like that's their downfall. They don't get that much vision. Ooh. And as we were just talking about that, absolutely gets annihilated there by End Limit doing so much damage. Has that Deathfire Grasp as well for extra damage. And now they're gonna move towards that top lane, trying to get in this tier 2, and they should be able to do so because they're quite strong at the moment. Maybe Equilibrium will be looking for an engage, I don't know, but it's quite risky. Unite are just gonna focus on that tower, facing the whole use, but hits Dalker. Razor at the side, just trying to get some damage done with his Void Spikes. And Unite and Limit jumps right into that with the Distortion, doing a lot of damage. Razor gonna target that Dalker. Tidal Wave being used as well, enabling him to jump right in. There is Boosh gonna be in the center of the fight. Flash is being used there by Equilibrium. They're trying to escape from this. They're under the tower. Dalker uses the ultimate jump right in, just trying to focus on people down. Double kill there for Kha'Zix. Zarya side trying to get something, but it's a bit of a sticky situation. Overextends just a bit too much. Now, Janna and Karthus, the only two left. Overstaying that. Ooh, just a bit too much. Here comes the Requiem. Will it take down anybody? Nope, but they are quite low. That's an inhibitor turret gone. They are going to focus down this inhibitor as well. All members of Unite quite low. They do end up getting this. The seconds left on the respawn of everybody. Looks like they might be going for a Nexus Tower as well. And then it jumps right in. Very close to fall into the tower. But they're going to back off now. They do get quite a few members.
Mm-hmm. And like we saw, that was a crazy team fight. And there's a TP coming in behind them from Dalker.
And Dalker, really bad place yet again. Here comes Toe Grinder onto Coco Pops. The Aqua Prison misses. He ends up falling in the end. Unite Boosh is gonna make his way out. The rest of the members are gonna recall. So it looks like Unite definitely have the strength this game. There's another tower falling in favor of Equilibrium this time. So, just all about Unite overstaying a little bit too much and getting taken down for that.
Yeah, with that top in him now, it's time to see what Unite do with this. I mean, with that top pressure being created itself by super minions, it looks like their next focus could be bot lane and or when that dragon spawns. And Dalga taking that bot lane tower.
Yeah, Dalga does manage to pick off another tower for his team. Here it looks like Clutch is trying to steal away the red buff and does manage to do so successfully. And then tries to jump in, but just he's doing that for a bit of harass. Here, looks like Unite are grouping towards that bot lane to get that tier 2. Equilibrium's gonna try and defend this as best as possible. We saw them do that before in the top lane, did not work for them. You need to be careful, and it's too dangerous as well because there's a huge wave pushing into the Nexus towers. So, Equilibrium, I don't think they should be sticking around for this tier 2. They should be backing off. This is too risky.
No, I mean, they send in now back and make a pick.
Yeah, they overstayed that a bit too much, and that enabled Enlem to jump right in and out, get himself a kill onto Nevermore. Now this will make it easier for them to take this tier 2 tower. Ace in the Hole being used yet again, managed to get blocked out there by Dalker.
And they, Equilibrium right now, should probably give this tower because their main source of wave clear is now gone. And yeah. Their jungler is one of their front line, isn't he? Now they have Dalker, however, they lack damage now with their mage, their main source of AD damage now gone.
Yeah, and they're gonna try and get this inhibitor turret here in the bot lane. Meanwhile, yet again, there's a bit of a wave pushing in that top lane, so it's really hard for them to try and defend, especially when there's a lot of damage going down to that tower and onto themselves as well at the same time. Dalker extremely low, he needs to back off. Unite are just going to focus this tower because that is the main priority at the moment. And here is Nevermore now trying to block them out, trying to clear those waves to prevent Unite taking those towers and try to stall out a bit as well while they clear that wave in the top lane. So this is constant back and forth, a little bit of poke here and there. Aqua Prison does land onto Nevermore. This gives Enlem the pick back to jump into the pond and knocks them back. Razor trying to get in front line as well. Tidal wave on to all of them. But it is really going to pretty bad places as well at the same time. That's a shutdown. Two kills for Unite. I'm going to try and back off because the Requiem is coming in now. Dalker is now this thing. It's finally gone down. Mr. Irish getting taken down by the Ace in the Hole. And Limit yet again taking another kill for himself. 10, 4, and 9. This is perfect now for Unite to try and close out the game. They are going to take that inhibitor and that inhibitor at the same time as well. So it's a matter of time before you get these Nexus towers as well. A good few seconds left on the respawn for Equilibrium. So Unite and then we're going to jump right in. How to down get again? Gets one another kill. We're focused Toe Grinder. That's two kills for himself. And the next tower goes down as well at the same time. They are now focusing the Nexus and Equilibrium trying to do as much as they possibly can, but there's no use. That is going to be the second win of this series going to Unite, and what a fantastic series as well, definitely showing their strengths.
Really well played for Unite, pulling that game back together. I mean, you saw the disadvantage in the early game in that bot lane. However, they played it well. The Kha'Zix damage was insane. They stored out long enough for the impact from Razor to really show. And we saw Boosh's impact as well in that top lane, picking up that GA as well. They were lacking a front line, as we see Razor building damage again. However, the GA really supplements it. We saw Boosh's damage, and now he built that GA and Randian's. That's enough of a front line. And they won the game by playing their team comp very well. They had really great vision, and they played the pick game extremely well.
Yeah, so that was a fantastic series. Well played to both teams. Congratulations to Unite taking the two wins in this two series. So now they do have 4 points under their belt for themselves. They're doing really good for themselves in their group, and they are part of Group A as well. So that is all from us, guys. I have been Komal, Komalala Ansari, and joined with me is Kevin Strike Chung. We will be back for more casts later this week as well. So stay tuned for that. Make sure you are part of the Irish eSport and gaming community on Facebook, so you'll know what times exactly the games have been streamed. So thank you very much for tuning in, and we'll see you guys later.
Bye.